The workers' education people lend us the so that we can continue our Friday lecture series. Tonight we are going to be talking about the learning and teaching of Chinese with the technology. And this is the topic of our discussion. And we are fortunate to have Professor Der-lin Chao, who is an associate professor at Hunter College, to come and talk to us. She comes with a lot of credentials. She got her PhD from NYU. She has written several textbooks and manuals about teaching of Chinese. And she has trained a lot of teachers. And her current interest project is a reconstruction of the history of Chinese language instruction in the United States. She has also been working on Chinese literacy development project and also to use web-based and multimedia instruction materials to help students achieve literacy in the Chinese more effectively. Please welcome our speaker, Professor Der-lin Chao.
Thank you, Dr. Tan, for giving me this opportunity to come here to share with you what we have been developing at Hunter College to use technology to solve a very critical issue for our field in teaching and learning Chinese. As we all know that right now, Chinese is a hot language. You know, people want to learn it. However, many times you hear people say, "Oh, I'm interested in learning Chinese, but I'm afraid that it's going to be too difficult for me." And when you go further step and asking them, "What made you think of that Chinese is difficult?" and they would tell you, maybe 99% of the time, that it's characters. On the other hand, they're also fascinated by this writing system because it's so different from the phonetic language they're used to read and write. So tonight, I'm going to just give you maybe 20 minutes of PowerPoint outlining the background and the reason and the methodology and the pedagogy of these materials. And then for the next 30 minutes, I'm going to show you what's in the website. And then I welcome questions. So let me move to the... Yeah, or do I need to? Okay, so the topic is teaching and learning Chinese. I don't see the screen here. As we all know, Chinese is difficult. So why do people, both natives and non-natives, please pay attention to that. I also include the native kids. They also think Chinese is difficult. That is because writing characters is the biggest learning barrier. So as teachers, what can we do to help students? We have observed different ways of teaching characters, and we conclude there are two ways. The first approach is the shortcut approach. That is, to delay the time of writing characters or learning characters by using phonetic symbols such as 波波摩佛 or 汉语拼音. So what students use to read or to write is through another media rather than the real authentic characters. And the other approach is the avoidance approach. The avoidance approach is you don't introduce, you want to attract students to come to your class, and you want to keep them. So you try to make a Chinese look very simple, and so you completely ignore teaching characters to students. And so, however, there are problems with both approaches. Okay, because the question really lies in this, is learning characters necessary? I think yes, and I hope all of you here tonight and think, yeah, it's true. Because knowledge of characters is essential for Chinese literacy. And if a beginning level student does not begin to build, to start at the beginning level, to build up a good foundation of characters, they will not be able to achieve advanced level proficiency. And this is a very critical issue and the problem that we face in the Chinese teaching field, where we have maybe 50 students in the first year class, and second year maybe drop 50%, and the third year maybe only 5 or 6 left. So that's because they don't know how to read Chinese characters fluently, so they are not able to handle the reading materials they use in the advanced level. So literacy skills and conversation skills are equally important. And we want to stress that writing characters, the literacy skills, require different kinds of skills from the to speak or to listen. Okay, here is some historical background of Chinese scripts. I mentioned earlier that characters, writing characters or looking at characters many of them find it remarkable. Because they know that studying a written script that has 3,000 years of history, the amazing thing is it is still actively used today. So I give you here my name in Chinese. So the three characters in my name, I'm sorry that the seal script didn't show the first row. It's 2,000 years old. And the second one is supposed to be Li Shu, but it didn't show here. And Kai Shu, I will show you when we go to the web materials. And the last form is the Kai Shu, which is the standard handwriting form. Okay. Oh, by the way, my name Zhao, the first character, Zhao, is a common family name, and De means virtuous, and Lin, unicorn. So that's my name. And the character writing skills, we have standard handwriting, Zheng Kai. We also have other variant forms, such as cursive handwriting, Cao Zi, or calligraphy styles, Zhuan Li Kai Xing Cao, and printing styles, Song Ming Kai. So I think the character instruction should not just limit itself to teach students know how to write the modern form, because characters has been used for so long. The old scripts have become like ornaments or artistic forms that we still see in modern days. And when they go to like museums, they'll see this, they'll see that. So we need to include all this knowledge into the materials. Now, how do native Chinese kids study characters? So here's my reflection on my own experience. Okay, kids go to school at the age of 6. So that's when most children started to learn writing characters. And so what is the lesson one? To write your own name, right? And you can see that that's my name that I had to write when I was this tall. Okay, so if you don't know how to analyze these three characters, which usually the teacher does not provide students with, how can a kid start to write these characters, okay? So the characters were too difficult for a six-year-old, that was me, to write. And so I was crying and crying, you know, it's not just to, the assignment I remember was not just to write one time, it's like write your name 100 times. And because the name has so many strokes and the foundation, the essential knowledge was not taught. So I didn't know where to start. And also, the teacher was not very helpful, and she said, well, why did your parents give you this such a complicated name? And look at them, you know, if you're taking a test, all the people will finished writing their tests while you're still writing your name. So I went home and I complained to my parents, and so they came up with a solution, okay? And they gave me a simplified name. So they changed the third complicated, because you cannot change your last name. That's very important for Chinese. And the third, they want me to be virtuous. So they want to use that. And for the third one, Lin Unicorn, which is really 24 strokes, okay, if you count it. So they changed it, homophonic word, character word, Lin. As you can see, this Lin has two similar components, left and right. So I was able to use this simpler name for my first grade. Okay. And solution two, for the first year instruction, is they use phonetic spelling system mixed with the characters, or Hanyu Pinyin, or Bo Po Mo Fo. Okay. And then, how do students learn characters? My experience showed that the teacher didn't give any instructions. They just asked students to copy the characters over and over again. So the misconception is rote memorization is the way to learn characters. And this is this has been used since I was little, and maybe is now still used in Chinese community school or in many classrooms at college or high school levels. And so students have to copy these the characters, and the result is the learning outcome is not satisfactory for decades. Because rote memorization, it's difficult to give you the clues or the help for long-term memory. So students think learning characters is dull and difficult. And teachers think, on the other hand, students do not learn characters well because they do not study hard enough. So there is a conflict, you know, whenever students complain that, oh, you give me too many characters, and the teacher says, you need to learn, you have to learn. If you don't work hard, of course you cannot write them well. So we want to change that situation and the tension between, you know, students with so much workload with rote memorization. And we propose that because characters are not adequately taught in class, students find learning characters dull and difficult. Okay. Challenges in teaching characters. The next question is, why don't teachers teach characters in class? I realized that there are two reasons that may be contribute to that problem. The first is controversies in character instruction. What characters should we teach first? When should we begin to teach characters? And how should we teach it? And how many characters we should assign students in first year and second year and third? And people just debate back and forth, and with many different proposals. But you see, Chinese like to discuss, but they hardly agree with each other. So every teacher has his or her own approach in terms of teaching characters. And I think the more fundamental issue is we lack of materials, methods, and tools for character instruction. So the teachers have to spend hours of time to gather materials and to present it to students. And so this is very time-consuming work, and the students do not have a consistent instruction for learning characters. And so sometimes they have to come up with their own methods, which may not be effective. And other challenges in teaching students, okay, there are 4 points. The first one is the diverse linguistic background. We know that many students, when they come to class, they have many have went to have gone to the Chinese community school or study abroad. So how because they all have a different background, how do you teach them and provide them with self-paced learning experience? And individual learning styles, some would like to, you know, they're a visual student, they would learn better with the visual materials. Some are more audio, they want to hear the sound, and some want to use computer, some want to use handwriting. So there are many individual learning styles we need to cope with. And by the teacher oneself, it's very hard to do that. And then there's very limited contact hours. We know that, for example, at Hunter College, only meet 3 hours a week. So with this 3 hours, you need to teach listening, speaking, reading, and writing, and plus characters. There's really no time for showing students the strokes and the details for learning characters. And so we need to prepare students for advanced level studies, so they will be ready to use Chinese in formal situations. We need to teach them characters. Okay, let's see. Okay, thanks. Attitudes toward using technology. So about 10 years ago, there was a big trend in the field of teaching Chinese to promote using technology in teaching and learning. And however, it has not made much progress because there are, you know, several kinds of attitudes. The first one is many teachers still think that technology is not useful, okay? And some think that it's too much trouble to change the curriculum because they've been using the same curriculum, and they feel comfortable using that curriculum. Adding technology, that means that you need to change everything and from scratch. So that's a threat. And the third one is it's for students who are looking for a shortcut. So some teachers think that, okay, technology, you just play games and you really have to make an effort to learn Chinese well. So we don't welcome technology. And then there's some commercial materials. However, these materials are either too expensive or poorly designed. So when we receive the examination copy and we just say, okay, it's good, but are we going to use it? No. Okay. And then students are doing fine without technology. I think most teachers think that for now, if it's not workable, then it's fine. the teachers who hold this attitude most come from the Ivy League schools. And you know that Chinese instruction started among Ivy League schools. They're the first patch. And so they think, well, yeah, we don't need technology. Okay. And then advantages of internet technology. So we started to think about internet that 5 years ago. And we found that internet technology has these advantages: accessibility, flexibility, affordability, interactivity, self-paced learning, self-monitored learning, outline, and classroom instruction. Okay, I'll welcome you, you know, to evaluate whether we have achieved that after I show you the materials. Criteria for design of effective technology-based material. When we design the technology-based materials, we need to know that the pedagogy is the core, not the technology. Technology is just to a tool that we can use to make the instruction more effective. So we need to think about 3 points: linguistically accurate content, and pedagogically sound learning methods, and accessible and interactive learning tools. Okay, so here is the design of our materials. We were very lucky to receive the funding from the U.S. Department of Education 4 years ago. So we have this financial assistance, and we could incorporate as much, you know, within the budget we can to hire web designer, and because it's hard to produce the material, and we want the materials to be useful for at least 10 years. And so this set of materials include a textbook that will provide detailed explanations and examples. I brought a copy with me today. So when we do the question answer sessions, you can circulate that and take a look. And after students learn the points in the textbook, they will go to the web-based. They will go to the website to use the web-based instructional pages to review. Using multimedia activities to review the points introduced. And then the third step is to do self-assessment. We provide exercises online for them to do this. And then when they finish that step, they need to use the workbook to further practice and review. And in the workbook, there are quick content-related questions from the textbook, and also handwriting practice. And then when they know the basics about learning characters, we provide them with online interactive learning tools so that they can do long-term self-paced and individualized learning. Okay, so here is our website, www.chineseliteracy.net. And materials, the package includes these. And the online interactive learning tools includes two basic tools. One is the 214 Kangxi radicals. Radicals are the most important character component. They, all the Chinese characters, 50,000, use this, are built up. You know, you can think about these 214 as the building blocks are built up by these 214 components. And for simplified character learners, we have we provide the 189 Xinhua radical learning pages. And then we have the 1,000 most frequently used characters in traditional and simplified forms. Why do we want students to learn the 1,000 most frequently used characters? Because students come to college, there are only 4 years of time for them to study Chinese. And so we want them to focus on the most important things. And surveys have research of the written reading materials show that even though there are 50,000 characters, there are only 3,000 characters that are used in the everyday reading materials. So we want to teach the first 1,000 during the first year. And most of the learning, after the teacher practiced the basics, student will do them at home, and teacher just check their learning outcome. Okay, and using characters as a gateway to gain essential knowledge in history and culture. Another advantage of teaching characters is through the etymology, development of Chinese scripts, and calligraphy, they know a lot of information about Chinese culture. And we also include this information in the material. And then, so once we have the materials, the next question is how to implement the materials into day-to-day teaching. I think we need to separate the learners according to their age. So we have four age groups. So when I demo the materials, think about if you are from high school or if you are from elementary school, think about how you can use this in classroom. And by the way, we are also now designing materials for younger children, like 6 to 8 years old. So I will show you, but that's still in draft format. Okay, now I'm going to demonstrate two parts. Part one is volume one. The goal of volume one is to master Chinese characters, and we use 8 chapters to achieve that. And these 8 chapters can be taught in beginning Chinese, first semester, 8 weeks. And it's sufficient for the teacher to spend 1 hour per week for classroom instruction. Because when we design the material, we know that how valuable the classroom time should be used for conversation. And so the materials can be used for self-instruction. And so if for college students, they can almost do everything at home. And so after these 8 weeks, students will be able to learn any characters, no matter how many strokes there are, by themselves effectively. And the second part I'm going to demonstrate is mastering Chinese scripts and other issues related to characters. And so students will learn knowledge essential for reading Chinese scripts, and so that they will find, when they go to the museum or go to an exhibition, they will, or even the couplets or the pieces of calligraphy work, they own in their family, they will start to know how to read them. Okay. And I think characters is really a nice gateway for to motivate students to explore more culture and historical issues. Okay, so a very simple conclusion is we need to continue to develop pedagogy and create better materials to make learning Chinese more interesting and efficient. And this project is definitely a beginning, and we want to do a lot more. And discover how technology can improve the quality of teaching and learning, maybe not just for Chinese, for Japanese, for all the foreign language instruction. This model may help Japanese and Korean students to learn Chinese character-based kanji and hangul. And then, I hope we can all work together to develop more technology-based instructional materials. Okay, so I will go to this Okay. The volume one is the 8 chapters I talked about. So this is the home page. You see, in these chapters here, it contains the instructional pages. So after student reads the chapter in textbook, they come here. And then in each chapter, there are main sections, and then the exercise. This is for self-assessment. So let me just show you. The first chapter, we talk about the formation methods of characters. So pictograph, indicative, ideograph, synonym characters, borrowed characters, and meaning sound characters. We present in the sequence that students know that why we need to develop, you know, more characters used with a different method. Okay, and so for example, pictograph. Okay, we have examples. Okay, and when they finish this, the definition is similar from the textbook. And then the indicative. Yeah, so they can play this. Yeah, so we use a flash so that students do not have to install a special program to read Chinese and the pinyin. Yeah, even though this took us a lot longer to create, because each flash file, yeah, is it requires many steps to create. So they know that this is ideograph character is yu and yue combined to be ming. And once they finish this, because this chapter contains some complicated concept, so we give them a review. And in the review, we give them categories of, because each of the characters. In Chinese, as we know, that each character has xing form, yi, meaning, and sound, yin. So, for example, we see that pictograph, they review this, and then we ask them to, like a game or a self-test. So they need to click on the characters they think are pictograph characters. So maybe we can do this together. Okay, which ones? Tell me. Here. Okay. So, correct, right? Okay, so it's a smiling face. Now, what if we choose this one? Yeah, so we give them immediate feedback. So try again. And this one, Ma. Ma is a pictograph character representing. So which one's Ma? Last one, right? Okay. Yeah, so four legs here. And yeah, the side, this is a Ma, the pictograph originally. This, right? Okay, sideways of course. This one definitely resembles the most the picture, and then it becomes this and this, and this is the today's form. Okay, so they can do these games so through interactive activities they can really grasp the meaning of the formation methods. And then we give them exercises they need to do. And so, for example, characters that appear to be drawings of tangible objects belong to which category? Which one? Pictograph. So, grade it? Yeah. Uh-huh. What if we have this? Yeah. Mm-hmm. So we give them feedback. Okay. And beginning is definitely the easiest. And if they finish beginning and scored like higher than 85, they can go to intermediate and then go to advanced. So when they finish, they can go to the second chapter, which explains the strokes, the basic strokes. We require students to learn the names of strokes, because when people refer to how to write the characters, they use their names. Yeah, so they can hear sound at home. They see this. They can even see a video of play. Okay. Yeah. Okay, they can see this. Okay, and then we divided the strokes into basic strokes, 折 compound. 折 compound. This 折 means bending strokes. And 勾 compound. 勾 means hook. Okay, and then combination strokes. Yeah, even though they have more turns, they're counted as one stroke. So 横折勾, we can see this.
横折勾.
Yeah. So students can practice this in a workbook or on a piece of paper. And then, again, they can do the beginning exercise. Yeah, they need to know which one is 点, which one is 横. So since we did 横, so tell me which one is 横. Number seven. Okay, so we type in seven. I can see here. I typed in a different one. But then we can check result. Okay, zero is correct. Okay. And then the third chapter, we teach them stroke orders. So once you know the basic strokes, now we can put strokes together. And we teach them rules. For the one component characters and two component characters and three component characters. So we build them, we want students to build up the block concept. So when they see a character, they know that it's not just individual strokes. It's a component. And they know that these components will be used over and over again. So they won't be scared and know where to begin. And so, for example, most characters are formed by two components. So we have this and play. So yeah, this left component is written first, and the second one is next. And then we have 你好, saying, and audio they can hear. 你, very, very low. And then the beginning and yeah, they can come here and tell, okay, how many components? Yeah, they need to recognize and indicate which component is to be written first. Okay, so they write one or two. Okay. So you see, these with color-coded and interactive, it cannot be done by, you know, the blackboard or just the traditional print materials. Okay, and then the fourth chapter, we teach 20 common radicals. And so they can click on the learning page and they see radicals, the animation and the sound and evolution, and see examples. Because the radical can appear in different positions of within a character. So they do this at home. So when teachers teach this chapter, they just assign students, okay, go to study website, and the next time in class, the teacher can open any page and then just ask student, okay, tell me what's this? What's this stroke? So student will say, Hang Shu, right? Yeah, and then what is the radical here? They will say, Tu, what's the meaning? So you can just check whether they practice. And chapter 5 is learning characters with 1 to 8 strokes, and also the learning strategies. Because if you want students to know the best way to learn, you better show them how, right? So we provide useful strategies for them to learn. And so, for example, they open this page. These are the radicals, by the way, yeah. From lesson 4. So again, the building block concept is here. So they can click here to self-test. Human. Yeah, they can reinforce their pinyin, spelling, first stroke, last stroke, and stroke count. Okay. So they do this 30 characters, all with the component, the radical component they studied in chapter 4, okay, and to learn the new characters. So they learn the new characters using the same way. Mm. Yeah, but with more items for them to study. Okay, and again, they can use this exercise to fill in the information. And then this chapter 6 is to learn characters with more strokes, 9 to 15 strokes, and also review strategies. We know that learning characters is a step. The next step, you know, maybe after 1 week, you forget all the characters you just learned. So you need to tell them how to review the characters. So we provide some review tools, and we tell students that they need to learn how to use the character. So in compound words, that's a minimum context, meaningful context, we provide them with. And so we give them 剪刀, 森林. Again, these characters are formed with the radicals from chapter 4. So they see the same radical again and again. Okay. So for example, 打破, they can use 打 and 破. And in this case, they know how Chinese compound words are formed. So we put two characters together, we combine the meaning of both characters. Okay, and then chapter 7, we know that now some people are, you know, want to focus on learning traditional characters, and some people want to learn simplified characters. I think for teaching Chinese as a foreign language, we need to teach both. And so in the textbook, in this set of materials, we introduce only characters with one form from chapter 1 to chapter 6. And because there are not really that many simplified characters, there are about 2,000 of them. So if you know the principles to convert traditional form to simplified form, it will be very easy for you to recognize both forms. So we categorize some principles for students, and we show examples. So this ho, first one is use the homophonic character. So ho, traditional, and this is also traditional, but with a different meaning. Originally means queen, but then, so ho lai is this character, wang ho is this character. In the simplification movement, this ho is removed. And use only one simplified form. So it tells you that a homophonic character with fewer strokes is borrowed and given a second meaning. So ho has two meanings and two tones right now. No, one tone. I'm sorry, this is wrong, okay? Just one tone. So ho lai and wang ho. So there are many more examples, like principle 6. We just use one part of the character. So, yi, okay, yi sheng. Yeah, this part is highlighted. Which one? We decided to use this one for the simplified form. Okay, and the stroke number reduced from 11 to 7. So, we teach them all the principles and they have to practice. I don't remember what this. Click on the following characters which have simplified form. Okay, this is the van, so they need to know which one has a simplified form. Yeah, do you know? Yi, san, si, wu, jiu. Yeah, yi, san, si, wu, jiu. Okay, and the other exercises. Okay. And then chapter 8, we teach students the concept of learning most frequently used characters. So I mentioned that there are 50,000 characters, but You only need to focus on the most frequently used, 3,000. And so we show them the teaching tools that I'm going to show you right away. And the students will learn that they need to build up this habit to learn characters and review characters regularly. This is very important. So up to now, the instruction part is over, and they have to, study and review, study and review. And we assign students to learn 50 characters a week. And so they will use the learning tool of the 1,000 character and the Kanji radical. So let me open this part. So for example, they in their language conversation book, there is a character which is 国家, the 国 means country. And they want to know how to write that character to learn that. So they can click the pinyin G-U-O. So 国 is here. So in this learning page, we provide all the information they need to learn about this character. Okay, so they can come to this page again and again to review and study and review. Okay, so pinyin. Can you hear 国? Okay, and definition. They can click to make the information away and self-test. Okay, and vertical, strokes. Okay, other component. In chapter 5, we introduce them. When they learn a character, they have to learn. Actually, they're learning two, because the 国 is one. Inside is another character, independent character, 或, meaning or. And word compound. This 国家 is, we prepare them to read newspapers, so we provide them with some 书面语, the written style, basic words. And the etymology, so students, they can just read this by themselves. It's color-coded. The early form of 国 is 或. A nation is defended by people, okay, represented by a mouth, who use weapons. This is a spear, okay, to protect the land here. And the radical way means enclosure, so you have your territory there. All right, and so the sound component is 火. So people, students would, reinforce their, this is a meaning sound component. And then they can also click the simplified and come to here, and they can do the same way, but see the strokes will be different, and the other component will be different. The word compound is the same, but written a little differently. And etymology, we give them the principle where they can they know how this character was converted to the simplified. Yes, to reinforce them the basic principles, and then back to traditional. So they can use this at home to learn the 1,000. Okay, and then go to simplified, go to, okay, volume 1. Okay, I want to go back this menu. Right, okay, now volume 2. Just very quickly, how much time do I have left? In volume 2, I have have 10 chapters. The first chapter, development of Chinese script, standard handwriting style, cursive handwriting style, development of printing and print fonts, Chinese calligraphy styles, your first calligraphy lesson, special characters where we introduce homophonic characters, and special characters, characters that look similar but easily confused. Methods of using a dictionary and practice using a Chinese dictionary. So let's start from the first chapter. Okay, so again we have instructional pages, a different layout. And by the way, we have two web designers who can immediately tell the design is different, and then the practice beginning advanced. And students can choose from simplified characters or traditional characters. Okay. Okay. So Chinese chronology. First, we build, give them, provide them with this information, and they can study the dynasties and do exercise, and they can see the oracle bones, pinyin, study the turn, and look at where Anyang is. Okay, and they can see Da Zhuan. Okay. Years and example and the simple script, yeah, Xiao Zhuan, yeah, Xiao Zhuan, okay, and then official script Li Shu, Li Shu, yeah, pictures, okay, yeah. So and so forth, all right, and then they will use them, they can practice, they can do this like it's even pretty difficult for myself, right? So students have to think about match and yeah, which one is which, okay? And they can check the answers, okay? And they can, I think, we can answers. Yeah, they know and play again. Yeah, for some exercise, we put the order in random each time, so they cannot memorize the answers. So chapter 2, handwriting style, one component. Yeah, so for example, they need to decide which character is written in the correct way, okay? And too big, not in the center, yeah, okay. So, and they need to move the character into the right spot, okay? So things like this. Let me show you the calligraphy chapter. Yeah, I know many teachers are interested in offering calligraphy lessons. However, I think in order to write calligraphy, students must have basic knowledge about strokes, stroke order, and the proportion of each component of that character. Otherwise, it's, you know, just you cannot really say that you're writing calligraphy. So we show calligraphy styles, introduce that. Zhuan Shu, the audio is kind of low. So we have the textbook introduce all this simplified and the traditional, okay. And calligraphy style tools, 文房四宝, so we teach them some useful terms and also reinforce their knowledge about characters. And now, so here they need to match. Which one is 转书? Yeah, okay, so for example, if I put it there, yeah, and if I put it back, I don't know if it's considered. So we need to play again. 行书, for example, this way. For example, just to check. Okay, how? And practice two. What dynasty they are? The calligraphers are from. So they need to recognize Yan Zhenqing, Zhao Mengfu, Ouyang Xun, Wang Xizhi, Liu Gongquan. Yeah, almost all Chinese people know these masters, calligraphy masters. I think our students also need to learn. And so, and then we have your Chinese calligraphy lesson where we provide, yeah, study the terms, they need to know how to hold the pen, brush, and so that. And then, we can play this. Yeah. This is not the right way to sit. Okay, and so home video, we can have, yeah. So, we shoot this backwards. We will do it again, but we haven't found the time. But they will see, and you cannot hear the audio. I said, qi bi, xing bi, shou bi. So they will learn different techniques required at the beginning and in the middle and the ending that stroke. So I think, that's all of the demonstration I'm going to do. I think I would like to know your comments and then maybe feedback because the most important thing is students, right? So how we can use these materials to benefit students, to help them learn characters. We can stop here and have a discussion or questions. Yeah. Thank you very much. Thank you. Yeah. Okay. Yes. Yes, please.
Do you use the multimedia as a supplement or instead of a substitute for displacement for the kind of old-fashioned traditional curriculum?
Okay. I explained at the beginning that literacy skills are different from conversation skills. So now we allocate two-thirds, because we have 3 hours, so two-thirds of 2 hours to practice conversation and 1 hour for practicing characters. But remember that only requires 8 weeks at the beginning. So after that 8 weeks, it's students' responsibility to learn characters that teachers assign to them. So I think literacy skills should be treated equally important as the conversation skills. So I would say that. However, if a student knows how to speak Chinese like heritage learners, they can use this as supplementary, and they can go faster, you know, to advance their literacy skills as much, you know, as they can.
I think the presentation is excellent.
Thank you.
It's a good way to introduce Chinese culture, mm-hmm. or Chinese characters.
Right.
For example, my American colleagues,
right.
are not fluent in Chinese,
uh-huh.
who are just curious.
Yeah.
Chinese culture in general.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think it's a very
uh-huh.
exercise for an optimist.
Yeah, thank you.
But, mm-hmm. you know, I still think that there's no substitute for mm-hmm. Hard work. You know?
Mm-hmm. That's true, very true. So we're not proposing a shortcut approach. It's you really have to do the steps to learn. Yeah.
I remember when I was a little kid, mm-hmm. I hate my teacher.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Right. Now, so the web materials is 40块钱, 一年 the membership. 那直接到这个网站上就可以 order.
这是
Hunter 做的，对，是我主持的一个项目。
如果是中文学校，我们自己学校order有没有special？这个我们可以要看数量是多少，而且这个呢，就是说，each
set is for one individual, we recommend the students use the textbook even if they're young. The parents can, it's written in English, you can explain to your children. Yeah, so, if you are interested, take a look at the.
Mm-hmm. You are working on some material for younger children.
Mm-hmm.
So is the textbook here today appropriate for young?
How young?
6 years old.
Okay, I'm going to show you. I haven't shown this to any public audience yet. Is it still on? Or you turned it off already?
Is it on?
Yeah, we're developing materials for younger age students. Okay. Maybe when it's Okay. 那没关系，以后再看好了，可能很麻烦。 Yeah, 我们是有这个 所以呢。 因为 because children have less time, attention focus, so we make each activity like 10 minutes. We try to use games and more interactive, so they don't have to read the textbook. Yeah, so they can just use the website and supplement it with some activities like songs or games or conversation. Yeah. I hope to. There are 10 modules. The first module is the 12 zodiac. We're half finished. The second module is Pangu, Kai Tian Di, Pangu, yeah. And each module, if you are going to use in the Chinese weekend schools, maybe a week, a month to 2 months, depending on how quickly they learn. But the thing is, because it's web on the website, so they can practice at home. You know, with parents, it's multimedia interactive, so yeah, more engaging than the Wang Da Zhong or other traditional textbook exercises.
So should
yeah.
we check with you?
Yeah, just email me, and I hope that the first two modules can be ready for field test, because we these products we have field tested it for 3 years, and we're still field testing it. And so, if you have comments, please let me know. If you're interested in field testing, yeah, of course. Thank you. And yeah.
Mm-hmm. In deciding whether you're teaching Chinese to second generation,
yeah,
is it better to teach them traditional characters or simplified characters?
Uh-huh. I think because simplified characters and traditional characters use the same set of principles, and so it really doesn't matter for them but I mentioned also that you need to provide them with all the information, so when they go to China or go to Taiwan or Hong Kong, they will have no obstacles reading materials. So in that sense, our approach is to show the principles using characters with one form, and then they can decide which form they want to study. However, we give them this channel so they can look at back and forth, traditional form and simplified form. And so, for example, my son, 9 years old, he used this. Yeah, I use him as a guinea pig. Yeah, and so once you are used to one form, you find, learning traditional characters is not a problem at all, because, and to me, just my personal feeling is that simplified characters, because it derives from a cursive writing, a lot of them, so the curve of the strokes sometimes are not that regulated, and so it's very hard to read or hard to write for children. Yeah, so I think the first 8 chapters teach about 200 characters, so if they know that, I think it'll be,
I noticed in the mm-hmm. textbooks there, you teach the characters primarily, and they seem to be isolated characters. Well, when you have your conversation, you have another textbook that will give them conversation so that mm-hmm. these characters will have meaning?
Yes. So again, there are two tracks. One is conversation, the other is characters. When you teach these 8 chapters, at the same time they learn the basics like grammar, speaking. However, they just recognize. The teacher would just ask students to recognize the characters without having to memorize each one. And so when they finish chapter 8, they will be ready to learn the characters on their own, and the teacher can assign the characters they already know how to speak to learn how to write, because we know that, you know, spoken language must come before the written language. And if you write a character that is not, you don't know the meaning, you don't know how to use, it's hard to remember. So, this also gives them a chance to recognize characters first, and you can use those characters in the conversation textbooks to reinforce the principles introduced in the character materials.
The conversation books?
No, I don't have conversation books. I think there are already plenty of conversation books developed. And what is not available yet is the character textbook. Okay. Yeah, I think I have my card I can give you. Yeah.
I'm just wondering about, you mentioned about dropout rates at the beginning, you know, mm-hmm. So what do you think about this, and how is it going to affect the dropout rate?
We don't have a scientific study yet, but we're collecting data to compare students' learning attitudes before they use this material and after. It's we never hear complaints from students saying that character is difficult to write. However, it again goes back to the gentleman's comment that you really have to study. Yeah, and so we encourage students that, we're not giving you a shortcut, you have to study, because you have the tools, you have the methods now. If you still cannot learn, it's your fault. It's not our fault, right? Yes?
How often do you advocate students write a character to learn, since they actually have to practice? How often do you recommend have found to the beneficial that they practice these characters?
It depends on each individual, and their background. So for Western students with no background, I would say, 1 hour at least per day. Because the learning cycle is learn, practice, review, self-test. So they have to go through this cycle again and again. If they find there's a need to learn, to study more, then
But each character, he mentioned 20 times when he was growing up. We have to practice these
20 times, yeah.
Is that still about the same?
I would say so. I don't know.
Some teachers require you to write the
same
character the whole page.
Yeah, yeah. But I think, if you know the radicals, the more basic knowledge you have, the less time you it would require you to learn. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
你这个整个的班算是以说话为主，是以写的为主。对对对。加一点点历史中国历史。对对对。说的东西多吗？说没有，现在没有说的，因为这个对话的还没有做，我们没有想到要做。 对对对，将来如果说有兴趣的话，大家觉得有需要的话，我们可以，所以需要大家支持来买这个，这样我们才可以有钱来做别的，呀。 maybe for teacher training, if they have no experience and you want to give them accelerated training program, you can just provide them with a good material and show them how to do it, and through using the materials they know, they learn how to teach. Actually, materials is really the core of the curriculum right now, especially when the teacher has no experience, because you know, how can you ask them to design supplementary materials if it's necessary, and that's a problem.
You can call this up, this program up on the web anytime?
Yeah, anytime. Not free. Yeah, you need to buy the textbook, workbook, and the membership.
Oh, how much is it?
$40 a year.
$40?
Yeah.
And have you used this in your classes?
Yes, 3 years.
How many years have you used it? And what are the results?
Okay, this is my third year using this, and using different types of classes with Western students and heritage learners. I have students last year who were able to learn 1,000, in 1 year. So that means you need to study and the first semester, and then make time to study and review in the winter session, and then the summer. Yeah, so we give them a post-test. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. For Western students.
Yeah, Western students. Western students. I think 500 characters is no problem. Yeah, but Hunter students. At Hunter, we only have like 5-6 Western students. Most of them are Chinese background. So I cannot tell you how useful it would be for Western students. But right now, University of Colorado and Duke University and two high schools, Middlesex School in Massachusetts and the Green Hill School in Texas are using. So I would wait to see the results.
What textbook do you use for beginners?
For the past 20 years, I used a Chinese primer. But now, I'm using the self-designed. We're designing a new course packet. In the conversation material, we still want to reinforce the character learning. So, and right now there is no no textbook. Using this approach. So, yeah.
第一是你在那边发布会的时候就参加。对对对对。谢谢谢谢。非常谢谢你做很好的工作。谢谢。可是现在需要推广。第二个建议就是，第二个我就想说点建议就是说。 你这个推广工作可以推广很多的中文学校，现在美国好几百所中文学校，对，可以跟他们介绍介绍。行，好啊。如果他们是很多人要的话，你们给他们一点试看，然后这样的话可以更多人用。好啊，好啊。如果你现在要请您去的话，可以吗？可以啊，做一个
teacher training
没问题。没问题。对，没问题。对。非常乐意。然后再还有一个建议就是，我看你里面只是英文，其实你那个说明可以用中文的。
说明可以用中文的，因为现在很多那个中文学校的老师的话，英文并不见那么好。对，所以我们现在
he
raised a question about to develop a teacher's manual in Chinese because a lot of Chinese teachers, feel more comfortable reading Chinese. So we're now writing that, If there is a need, we'll certainly consider doing it. Like I said, this took us 4 years to do, and so I don't know if I still have that much energy, to continue. But I think I will. I think I will if the response is good. Yeah.
Just looking at the technology of something, mm-hmm. it's not a. Student of Chinese mm-hmm. self, but it seems to be really exciting as an exciting way to learn how to write your language mm-hmm. as a written language. I'm wondering if mm-hmm. you will have a better idea, because if you've been using this for the last 3 years, mm-hmm. I'm wondering, will you and your colleagues have a pretty a better idea, let's say another 2 years, let's say mm-hmm. 5 years,
mm-hmm.
what the success rate is of this new program? Or do you have an idea of that now?
I don't have an idea now because I would love, to, you know, if some colleagues at college or in high school or in Chinese school would like to, you know, joint with me to do a research project.
Like keeping stats.
Yeah, keeping stats, and then we can do like longitudinal study and see, you know, compare the outcome. Yeah. Right now, the general requirement for beginning level students is to learn 300, you know, it varies from school to school, 300 characters to 500 characters in one form. And so I think if we could achieve that standard and, you know, or go beyond that standard, that would be success, right? And so, yeah, but it requires, you know, some planning and you know, the candidates who want to do this, and yeah, that's a very good suggestion. Thank you. Yeah.
Have you compared your methods with the Yale system and the Vertis system?
The Yale system, I don't know what you refer to, the Yale system.
I think they use the alphabet.
The alphabet, yeah, the first year, and then teach characters in the second year.
Yeah.
I think this is somewhat different from, that's the delay approach, is that we provide students with basic knowledge. Yeah, so if they just delay the time of introducing characters or assigning characters for students to learn, using the traditional method, it will be the same. Yeah. Then it just requires students more time and more effort and more struggle, yeah, frustration, etc. Yeah, but one little footnote for that gentleman's suggestion. My son, yeah, use him as an example. He went to the Chinese school for one semester, and he didn't learn 10 characters. Yeah. And he was frustrated every time he had to write a homework, you know, crying, banging on the table, you know, why do you want me to study Chinese, complaining. And so last year I was on leave, so I was home, and during the Christmas break, I started to just use this, only the web, not the book, to teach him. And now he knows about 200. Of course, the learning was like, you know, it's you cannot compare a teacher and with students teaching your own children. And so, he feels confident when you give him a new character. You know, he can just write with pretty much the accurate stroke order. Yeah, you know, for the character that he sees the first time. So that's I think it shows that, you know, if about nine years old, can absorb the concept from doing the activities. I think it will be, you know, pretty easy for an adult. I can only say that. Yeah. Okay. Let me see if I can show you the.
Oh, you turned it off.
Oh, turn it off again. Okay. Okay. Let's see.
You mentioned flashcards. Is it possible for us to see how that
could
be used?
Flashcards, it's all on the website.
Oh.
Yeah, uh-huh. Yeah. Okay.
You need to remember to enter the website.
Yeah, that's true, right.
how long is the membership?
1 year. And you can renew the membership for $5-$10. Yeah.
Can you purchase the textbooks to be on the website as well?
Yes. Yes. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Or you can give me yours, and so I do. Give me your. Right. Okay.
I don't have payment.
Okay.
Uh-huh,
这是我自己的
okay,
Yeah, okay
好,不谢谢
那我想她 she's going to leave then it's fine because it's still a draft version but I just you know, the design for the children's material is different from the adult material. We use more games and cartoons yeah, okay.
Professor Chao will stay around for more questions, but we really appreciate the wonderful lecture. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for coming. Thank you. Thank you.